Do.
So today we're going to talk about food waste. It's a problem that we face all in the U.S., but also a lot of other countries in the world, and it's causing some damage. So whatever's going to take a few minutes now, and think about what these values are in reference to. So we're going to talk to you. What is how about this table to share with the table? What did you guys say?
We said that we think it's like food production and like the resources, like the amount of our resources that go into it. Like 80% of our fresh water goes into the food production
area. Okay, what is your answer? Anyone ready to go ahead?
We were saying, at least I was thinking that like that last, like the amount of money that's being used annually.
So why does 40% of our food get wasted when these values are so high? And I read that a little bit. why does 40% of food doesn't make it to our tables? That's not even just wasted. 40% doesn't make it to our tables. It's because we're wasting it. Our text today explains why food waste is a problem in America. Describe what is causing food waste, list strategies for reducing food waste, and identify strategies that we can easily apply in our own lives to reduce food waste. So first off, why should we care about food waste? First, one in every American are food insecure. Mm-hmm. I mean, they are struggling to find a meal out of their everyday life. Where they're really going to get their next meal, one in eight. Also, think about you're coming out of the grocery store, you got four bags of groceries, you drop one, and you just keep walking. Who would do that? That's weird. And we waste money, a quarter of our money we use on food, just by throwing it out every year. And we look back at these values again. That's all those resources that are wasted when we don't even eat 40% of the food that we grow. We also add a lot of volume into landfills by the food we throw out, our food production process. Now, look at these two pictures. A banana peel thrown on the sidewalk and a banana peel put into a landfill. Which one do we think is worse or better?
I think the banana peel on the sidewalk is probably better because it's biodegradable.
greenhouse gas that is more than 20 times as potent as CO2 or trapped in heat.
That's right. When we dump food into a landfill, we're essentially throwing a trash blanket over a fraction of food time and dumps opening the entire planet.
So that's, when the food goes into the landfill, like I said, these traps and producing methane, which adds to that, we're wasting all the work. Emitting carbon dioxide when we're traveling the food, when we're processing it, and also when we don't eat it and it goes into a landfill, we're producing greenhouse gas that's way more potent than carbon dioxide. So what's causing us? We know now why we should care, why it's bad, but now what's causing it? Usually imported products don't even make it off the farm. As that 40% doesn't make it to our table, 40% don't even make it off the farm because they just don't look right. That's what we said. Kind of explain.
I learned that what I was actually finding is the tip of the food waste iceberg. What I was finding pales in comparison to what is being wasted at farms before it ever hits the grocery store shelves. This is Tristan Stewart, founder of Feedback here in London. They do farm-level research, investigation of how much food is going to waste. Here he is standing with a pile, a giant pile of bananas that are going to waste in Ecuador because they're the wrong shape, either too much like a U or too flat, or because they're too big or too small. Here are thousands of cauliflower going to waste because they're either too big or they have a slight tinge of yellow or purple food, not the white that you're used to seeing at the grocery store. And here is a truck full of parsnips, one of many that this farm wastes on a weekly basis. These are all being wasted because of the wrong shape, color, and size. So by now a lot of you are
So that food being wasted right off the farm, it's not just the farmer's problem, it's not farmers making a bad decision and hurting the earth or whatever. It's a problem that's caused at every level of that food's journey. It's being caused at the farm, it's being caused by what grocery stores will buy, it's being caused by what our consumers will buy from the grocery store. It's a systemic problem that has multiple levels to it. Now, let's look at these two boxes of donuts. Which box would we rather pick from?
That's the one that's more whole.
It is about the same amount of donuts, though. Similar selection. So this is what happens in our grocery stores. Grocery stores overstock food to make it look better. When there's only a few things, even though there's pretty much the exact same amount of selection, the same types and same numbers, but when there's only a few left sitting around, it doesn't look as appealing. It doesn't make you want to buy those ones. You're like, what's wrong with those? Why are they the ones left? So grocery stores overstock by a lot. Like this. A large percentage of these food isn't going to even be bought. And grocery stores know that. They know this food isn't going to get bought, but it's not going to get sold if it's not on a full shelf. Also, consumers buy a lot more food than they can eat. We throw away billions of dollars every year from our own kitchens just by letting food go bad before we can eat it. Who would eat a product after they saw it, say, the 17 foodies?
When do I see it? I see it today. Oh, 2 days after.
Well, yeah, let's say you saw it today. I mean, today,
yikes.
2 years later, would you eat it?
No.
It'd be a little, this is canned food, these and boxes, and it'd be a little sketchy. But what if it was December 20th, 2017?
Yeah.
What if it was past this date by a couple days?
Eggs stay good for quite some time. It's like the sell by different, or sell by is like different than like used by date.
Yes.
So.
Yeah, just like sometimes, like if you look at something and you
I mean, it's not the FDA because they're not required to put expiration dates on food except for baby formula. The only thing that has to put food on, so if you're eating baby formula still, then it's the thing. But like, they don't really need to be. But there's no law that companies have to put expiration dates on their products. Most of the time, it's to give them, it's to get you to eat it when it's the tasting the best, but they don't want you to eat this product when it's lost its freshness and it's tasting bad. Or they just want you to have to buy more sooner. A lot of times these expiration dates or sell-by dates are more of a marketing thing or a product like, more quality rather than safety standard. So if your food is like, as long as it doesn't smell bad, it's probably okay. Because we throw a lot of food away before the expiration date, but also stores, grocery stores, they can't sell it when it's past the expiration date because who's going to buy it? They see this one before the expiration date, one after, who's going to buy it? They have to throw it away. And finally, how can we reduce our food waste? First off, we can buy ugly produce. It's super easy when you're at the store. It's kind of hard sometimes because you see the one that looks awesome and you're like, why don't I just get this one over there? But if you take that one that's ugly, you think about it, you're saving that from the landfill, you're reducing our body landfill, you're also reducing global warming. So it's a super easy choice to just take a bruised apple, and with that bruised apple, one thing you can do if you don't want to eat it, it looks weird, you can make apple butter with it. Super easy. There's a lot of other recipes too you can make that you process the food into something different so you don't have to see how ugly it was at first. Also, we can donate and reuse what we don't eat. One way we can reuse it is to compost it. Composting is not that hard. There's a lot of tools and things that you can do now that makes it a lot easier. There's also companies here in Tucson that will pick up your food waste and compost it for you. And then we can bring it back if you want the compost from it. The compost can be in your kitchen, super cheap, $30. It blocks the smell, so you can leave your food sitting in there for a while. Also, you can get outdoor tumblers to make it really easy. You can just kind of put your food in there, you turn it every once in a while, keeps it aerated, so then it's not producing methane because it's decomposing with air. You can also do this in this is like $80-$90 on Amazon. You can also just do it out in a wooden box outside. Also, if you have leftover food, you can donate it. The Community Food Bank of Southern Arizona is always needing more food, so if it's not open already and you're not going to get to it, go ahead and donate to the food bank. One other thing that would help is to only buy the exact amount of food you need. One way you can help yourself do this is when you're throwing out something, write it down somewhere how much you're throwing away so you know next time you buy that to buy that much less. You can also support businesses that are fighting to decrease food waste. I know DoorDash, they have a service where they pick up food waste from restaurants to get composted. Won't be fooled by expiration dates now. Only you can still eat it as long as it doesn't smell bad or taste bad. The expiration date really doesn't mean that much. Build support policies that reduce food waste locally and at the national level. Right now, there aren't any bills coming up, but a couple years ago, there was a bill that would have given tax breaks to companies that were decreasing their food waste and by donating all their leftover food. So a lot of grocery stores throw out tons and tons of food. You can look at videos about Walmart dumpsters. Tons of perfectly good food still packaged. But what are you giving tax breaks to companies who would have donated that? And the 40% of our food now are making to our table, that would do a lot to help food banks and families in need. Sadly, that bill went into the Senate, passed the House, into the Senate, and they kind of gutted it. And the weird thing they do, they can just take everything out of the bill and change the name and then put way different things in it. It's weird, so that bill did not get passed pretty much. But when you see things like that come up, send your congressperson an email. It's super easy. You can do it at the state level and national level. It's a great way to enact change. So let's think about our own lives and how we can each enact a change. On these papers I'm passing around, the strategies I've got, then go ahead and write down. Go ahead and write down in this spot below how we can enact change to reduce the food waste in our own lives.
Okay, perfect. Remember to be giving Angus great feedback on your peer critique form, then Tristan will get set up and we'll get moving along. Mm-hmm.